Good afternoon, students. Welcome back to SBR online classes. That we have started geography part, North American Ant of Prairies. That I will continue today also. Students, you learned so many things about North America, land of prairies. You learned, before start the next point, just recap which things you have learned, which points you have learned. One is North America location, then extent, physical setting, physical division, rivers and lakes, then climate and natural vegetation, wildlife, important minerals, and industries. Agriculture and important crops, then now location, extent, physical setting, physical division, rivers and lakes, climate and natural vegetation, wildlife, important and industries, agriculture, and the important crops of North America. Now, the last point is about the population. About the population of North America. These are all the things you have learned in North America. Yes, sir? Now, the last point is population of the North America. Afterwards, we will give the notes of this lesson. Most of the North Americans are descendants of Europeans, of American Indians, and Africans. Although there are some native or indigenous people, most of them speak Spanish, English, French, or American Indian languages. Most of the North American people, they have descendants, means they are a person. Descendant means what? A person or a plant or animal that is descended from a particular ancestor. Or another, the similar word for descendants is successor. And here the most of the people are European or American Indians and also the Africans. They are some native people also where they. And here the people, the language, the spoken language is Spanish, and they also speak English and also French or American Indian language they used to speak. Next, population density. Population density is the highest in the highlands of Mexico and Central America. But much of the northern part of the continent, see, northern part of the continent is almost empty because the situation is not suitable for the human being. So there is a less density, especially the frozen for north. In that area, in that climate condition, the population density is very less. What is the meaning of density? Population density. Population density means it is the measurement of the population per unit of area. Per unit of area, that is the measurement of the population. That is called the population density. In which area, which countries have the highly populated countries in North America? The densely means highly populated countries. The densely populated parts of USA are urban centers and industrial regions are densely populated. And here 98% of the population is urban. 98% of the population is are there. 98% of the population are settled in urban areas of the North America. The population of the Caribbean islands is less because that is a island area. So that's why the population is less. But settlement is dense. Population is less, but settlement is looks dense. What is the reason? Because due to the limited availability of the land, that is the land area is very less, that's why the population is less, then also it looks densely populated because of the availability of the limited availability of the land. So this is about the population. So these are all the complete North America lesson has completed. See, once again I comes to with the headlines of the lesson, main points of the lesson, the location of the North America, where it has located, then extent of the North America, physical setting of the North America, physical divisions, which are the important rivers are there and lakes are there in North America, climate and natural vegetation, wildlife, which are the animals we found in the North America, which are the minerals we found in North America, and where we found in North America, which countries, these, and next, agriculture, how the agriculture has developed in North America, which are the important crops they are growing in North America. And next, the last point there, about population, you have learned, students. Maybe hope you understood the lesson. Now, I will give the notes. So, you have to write the notes in your notebook. See, first I will give you children the fill in the blanks of the lesson. Fill in the blanks, match the following and exercise questions, and also we are giving the extra questions also from this lesson. The first bit is fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. Okay. What is the answer, students? First, who has discovered the North America? North America was discovered by Dash in the year 1501. Is that? The answer is Amerigo Vespucci. is the biggest peak in the North America. Which is the biggest peak in North America? The Mountain McKinley. Mountain, Endings Mountain, McKinley, McKinley. River, River Dash and Dash are the great rivers of North America. Which are the rivers? River Mississippi and Missouri. Mississippi and Missouri. The Dust Bowl storm devastated agricultural land in America. The Dust Bowl storm devastated agricultural land in America and Canada. This storm destroyed the agricultural land in the 1930s in North America. The next is the old faithful geyser is a world famous geyser in the in the USA. USA Yellowstone National Park. Yellowstone National Park of USA. Yellowstone National Park of USA. Next, agriculture is an important occupation of North America. Agriculture, it is an important occupation of North America. Desert desert snipes are called, what students? Desert snipes are called dash of deserts, that is winters of deserts. Desert snipes are called winters of deserts. Next, once again, we'll repeat this. North America was discovered by Amerigo Vespucci in the year 1501. Mountain McKinley is the biggest peak in the North America. Third, River Mississippi and Missouri are the great rivers of North America. The Dust Bowl storm devastated agricultural land in America and Canada. The old faithful geyser is a world famous geyser in the Yellowstone National Park of USA. Agriculture is an important occupation of North America. Desert snipes are called winters of deserts. Next, 8th one. Now 7 is completed. Now 8th one. Wheat is one of the popular cereals in North America. Wheat is the one of the popular cereals. Which is the first mineral mined in North America? Gold. What is that? Gold. So, gold is very first mineral. Which are the cash crops of North America? Tobacco and cotton. Dash and dash are grown as cash crops. Cash crops in North America. Cotton and tobacco. Cotton and tobacco are grown as cash crops in North America. These are total 10 fill in the blanks of North America. Next is, wheat is one of the popular cereals grown in North America. Gold is the first mineral mined in North America. Cotton and tobacco are grown as cash crops in North America. Next is, match the following. Next bit is as the following. Here A, part and B. 1. Play super year. Total 5 important plays I told you students while explaining. So what is together when they are called as homes? Isn't it right? Huron, Ontario, Michigan, Erie, and Lake Superior. Isn't it? Lake Superior, it is the fresh water lake. Lake Superior, fresh water lake. Next, I will continue this side. People who are engaged in lumbering, they are called as lumberjacks, isn't it? People engaged in lumbering, they are called as number jacks. See, lumberjacks. Okay. Sugar power of the world. Earlier, Cuba is known as sugar bowl of the world. Now, Brazil. But we are earlier sugar bowl of the world. Which one earlier? Cuba. The Grand Canyon. The Grand Canyon, it is a natural wonder of the world, isn't it? Why California is famous? It is famous for wine. So it is called the wine country because Chicago. It is known as plastic industry. Plastic industry. Pittsburgh. It is known as Steel City. Steel City. Next, I will continue this slide. Look at here, students. Lake Superior, fresh water lake. People engaged in numbering, lumberjacks. Sugar bowl of the Gulf, Cuba. The Grand Canal, natural wonder of the world, California. The wine country, Chicago. Plastic industry, Pittsburgh Steel City. Next. Mexico. Mexico is famous for silver. Maize is a corn. Students, first one is fill in the blanks and next is match the following. And next is answers. Answer the following. Next, here our questions are answer the following update. One is name the following. The in exercise question, fifth is name the following. Name the important plants and animals of North America. So first we will copy that, then answer the following. Name the important plants and animals of North America. Third book is name the following. Name the following. Okay, question number one. Here only one question is the name the following. The question is name the question. Name the important plants and animals of North America. Name the important plants and animals of North America. The answer is first. Silending plants. Cypress. Oak. Chestnut. Mahogany. Beech, birch, cactus, etc.
example. Cypress, oak, chestnut, mahogany, maple, beech, birch, cactus, etc. Second is animals. Reindeer, caribou, polar bear, Arctic foxes, next year. These are the important plants and animals of North America. Plants, cypress, oak, chestnut, mahogany, maple, beech, birch, cactus, etc. Animals, reindeer, caribou, polar bear, Arctic foxes, lynx, sable, silver fox, beaver, black bear, muskrat, porcupine, etc. These are the important plants and animals of North America. Now, the next bit is answer the following. Answer the following. The question is, mention the location and extent of North America. Mention the location and extent of North America. First side heading is location. First point. Where the North America has it located and its extent. Location. North America is located entirely to the north. This side I will explain. To the north. Lies within
lies within 19 degree north to 71 degree north latitudes. And 15 degree west to 150 degree west longitudes. The topic of cancer that is 23, 1.5 degree north passes through the continent in the south. This is the location of the North America. Here the question is location and extent. Both we have to write. Isn't it? First we have completed location of the North America. See, location, North America is located entirely to the north of the equator. It lies within 90 degree north to 71 degree north latitudes. 15 degree west to 150 degree west longitudes. The topic of cancer, 23, 1.5 degree north, passes through the continent in the south and Arctic Circle in the north. This is location of the North America. Now extent. The second point is extent. Extent of North America. Is the third largest continent in area. In the world, after Asia and Africa, it is almost 7 times means 24.24 miles per kilometer bigger than India. They are 24 countries in North America. North America is the third largest continent in area, that is 16.4 in the world, after Asia and Africa. First is Asia, second Africa, third is North America. And it is almost 7 times bigger than India. Total, there are 24 countries are there in North America. And the Caribbean islands are also area included in the physical area of North America. North America is one. And here, there are 22 countries in North America. The Caribbean islands are also area included in the physical area of North America. Now, first question we have completed. Now, next question. Make a list of important countries of North America. Question number 2. Important countries are answer Canada, United States of America, important countries of North America. Canada, United States of America, and Mexico are the important countries of North America. Students, remaining notes I will give you in the next class. Hope you understood clearly. If you have any doubt, you can message me that number 9148109945. So, okay, thank you. Have a good day. Take care.
Thank you.